We are just seconds away, folks. And here comes our referee for the night, Harmon Jason. I'm pretty sure it's not bullshit. But anyways, I'm sure if Jay's here, he will prove himself again. Just like he always does.
How he cheats and pussy out, but that's not the case. This week's that we're wanting to know what's going to happen tonight. Starting out, what's going to happen up first? We see Harmon Jason, our referee tonight, as always, coming out to the ring. We're also waiting to see who comes up to line up.
Let's get this straight. Jay is not a pussy. He does not cheat. He is not Mr. Monopoly. He is the man, the myth, the legend. Mr. Hiccupley, just zip your lips.
Well, without that being said, let's just see who comes out first.
Well, you know I'm right, so, I mean, there is no reason to sit and argue with me.
I don't know how you say
truth.
I am right whatsoever.
I speak nothing more than the truth.
Well, whatever. Let's
At that. We are starting our show off with Jay Alexander Frost.
Let's see what the
person
is this time. God.
Amazing.
And this is why I say he's not a pussy, and I can see the fans agree with me. He sucks, he cheats, and oh yeah, that's right. He hates Vince as much as I do, so everybody hates Vince. No, Andy, you actually let me talk for a while, man.
Zip your lips, Jay's about to speak.
They don't even deserve to talk, but oh well, let's give them a chance.
Yep. You don't deserve it.
All right, 1-2-1-2, is this microphone working? Yes, it is. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to VAW Elite, starring J. Alexander Frost. I am the man, the myth, the legend, and I'm here because you people cannot live without me for one single week. And that's the fact. Some people ask me questions that are unjustified. People ask me questions why, I don't know where they get this, why I used a diamond stud breast knuckle against this dragon fella, this friggin' lizard. Let me tell you one thing, people. I did not use any illegal weapons or foreign objects in that match. I just knocked him out with my bare hands. And the referee saw something that was never there. And that's the fact. People only see what they want to see. And the referee, you Harmon, yes you, you are all in a conspiracy against J. Alexander Frost, the man, the myth, the legend, me, the Intercontinental Champion. You all the idiots out there, that are out here surrounding the ringside area. Except, you know, some exceptions, of course. You all want to see me fail. You all want to see me go down. You all want to see me losing my championship belt, losing my matches, and losing my, well, superstar status. Guess what? It ain't gonna happen. Or for all the people who don't speak English or don't know what the heck, you know, is going on. This is a thing that will never happen in my lifetime. Because I am the man, the myth, the legend. I am the best professional wrestler that you guys will ever see in your life. brings me to another topic. Why does a man boy like Michael Carson get a title shot, well, or a number one contendership for the World Heavyweight Championship, and me, the Intercontinental Champion, I don't get zip, nada, nothing, nichts? Why is that? I have a theory. Why? Because, well, he's better at kissing ass, and I don't kiss ass. Yes, he totally does suck. I totally agree with you people. He fucking sucks. Just like, you know, when I look around here, you know, I'm pretty sure you guys are pretty good at sucking too, but sucking is one thing that J. Alexander Frost does not do. I win matches, fan square. 1, 2, 3. I don't have to use any foreign objects, but this guy, he gets one shot and now he gets the, you know, his number one contendership for the World Heavyweight Championship. I am the Intercontinental Champion. I won this belt. I am next in line to become the World Heavyweight Champion. It's my birthright to become the world heavyweight champion. But again, Vince Aftermath doesn't get his head out of his ass. And he wants to play games. And he uses Michael as one of those little play figures. And he uses all of you sheeps. And he uses all of the other people that he can get his hands on. Because he is Vince fucking Aftermath. And he thinks that he can play games with me? No. That. He wants to play games? Well then, Player 2 just joined the motherfucking game. I'm coming for you, Michael. I want this number one contendership. And Dragon, if you don't stop calling me, spamming me with your fucking emails, I will knock you out again. And again. And again. And again. Until my knuckles bleed. That's a promise. Oh yeah. Because the man, the myth, the legend doesn't do threats. He makes promises. Because he's the man, the myth, the legend. Hit my music!
Alright, there you have, folks. The man, the myth, the legend. Jay Alexander Frost saying he is going after Michael Parson. He wants that number one contendership. Definitely needs two belts. He deserves that shot, not Michael. And here we go. This match is scheduled for one fall. Hailing from the sewers of Necropolis, standing at 6'3", weighing in at 245 pounds, Slade. Death Valley, Standing at 6'9", weighing 300 pounds, Rat.
Welcome to the home of the hillbilly. Yeah, baby, it's a land of barbed wire, moonshine, whiskey. Park your car before you get stuck. Gonna grab you a beer and get all up in the truck. It's going down tonight. It's all on me. It's BYOB and I got all we need. Yeah, boy, I'm about to show me a set of slicker. How to kick it in the sticks with the critters down on the outside of the bomb wire. Money grows and rolls. If it don't, you're gonna broke. So we hang out by the bonfire. Just a good old boys having a dang good time. We crank it up. Bikers, they all came to kick it in the sticks.
Well, these two have been going after each other for a long time about right now. So this is going to be interesting, who's going to win the match. If it's going to be Slade or will it be Wrath?
You know, I kind of wonder what exactly Wrath did with that 1.5 mil that he got from Jay. He must have spent it on hookers and booze, because
either that or he bought himself a lot of motorcycles. After all, what happened to last time?
A lot of motorcycles.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, the match is underway, and Wrath already with that vicious right hook. And Slade tries to defend himself, but it's no use. Literally one after another. This cannot be going too well, as both of them are going right back at it.
Ooh. And a big knee to the gut from Wrath. Bringing Slade down to his knees.
Well, on due side, I believe Wrath might win this one due to fact he is more powerhouse than anything. And Slade, I'll say he's more technician. And I don't think Slade has nothing that Wrath needs at the moment.
Really? Well, I'm going to go with Slade is going to win this match. Strictly because even though Wrath has size and weight on him, as we've seen before, that means absolutely nothing.
That is true, but do factor in, it'll be really hard to call by this one. Big boot connecting, and you still saying you wouldn't let Slade win this one? I don't
Absolutely.
Think so, the way Wrath is playing around at the moment.
Just because Wrath has control of the match right now, that does not mean anything. It is still very early.
But that may
Ooh.
Be true.
See that?
Gee. Yeah, I'd give you props on that one. But literally, did I say Wrath is just playing with him, just toying with him. Let's see what Slade has to offer.
Ooh, and Slade's going for a pin. And a two count, and Wrath kicks out.
Lord, did you think Wrath would win it just like that?
Hell?
Thank you very much for your donation, Omega.
But you gotta give credit. Slade is already trying his best at the moment.
I didn't think he would win just like that, but he does have control right now.
And that is true until otherwise, that's for sure.
Gosh, you are so negative.
Oh! This one I'm talking about.
Oh, and Wrath with a gorilla press slam down onto the mat.
Yeah, no doubt about it, though. This would definitely be tough to call.
Slade has got to be feeling that in his lower back.
No doubt about it after that slam.
And Wrath with the punches to Slade against the ropes. Isn't that illegal?
Technically, but I don't think so.
Harmon, pay attention.
Yes, we did not want a sleeping ref on the job. Hey, see, we got some fans already cheering for either Slade or Wrath. I'm looking at the signs, so.
And Wrath looks like he's setting Slade up. What's he gonna do here?
This cannot be good at the moment. And you can just literally hear the chant, fans cheering for Wrath. And this is why you want to pay attention to Wrath, because you never know what he'll do next. Just like that, you know for a fact Slade is in pain.
Wrath is going to go with a vertical suplex. Wrath going for a pin here. One, two. No, Slade kicks out.
Like I said, this is definitely going to be one tough call match, folks. Like I said, probably Wrath is going to win it, but who knows with Slade. This is definitely going to be tough to call.
And Wrath with a huge Irish whip to the ropes.
And it looks like Slade is now tangled up on the ropes because he cannot get out.
Oh! And a leaping shoulder block knocks Slade out of the ring!
And almost hitting the commentators. Jeez, Wrath, just throw him back in.
And Harmon, shouldn't you be counting right now? And there he goes. Harmon up to the three count. These two need to get their asses back into that ring. And an Irish whip to the barrier. I don't know. I think Wrath needs to focus more on getting back into that ring.
No doubt about it. And referee is just sitting there telling them to get back in the ring.
And Slade gets back into the ring.
No doubt. Wrath is literally right now on spinner out. I'm trying to figure out what's going on with him. Oh, and a flying swanton bomb from, it looked like a running swanton from the corner.
Slade, you better get him back in the ring. You cannot win pinning him outside of the ring. And Raph very possibly may be knocked out cold. He is not moving. Oh, there he goes. What were you saying, Red, about Raph being big and being able to take Slade and everything else? I don't know. It's not looking that way right now.
Not just yet. That's why I'm saying that Raph is just toying with Slade at the moment. To me, I think he's not
like
even...
He's toying with anything. And both men are back into the ring.
Now we get to see who's going to start kicking some ass. And you can hear some of the fans telling Raph and Slade to start kicking their ass, that's for sure. And already they're going right back at it with the punches and kicks. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to remind the fans to please stay out of the barrier before you get sniped. So, Mr. J, please hop out before a sniper snipes you and you get kicked. Thank you. Anyway, back to the show where Slade is right now dominating throughout the match right now. Just he's going with a kick gut and run to. Wait, what's he doing? See what I'm talking about?
Oh my god.
Raph was faking it the whole entire time with the Samoan drop.
Ooh. You could see the ring shake on that one.
No doubt about it, and it shook, that's for sure. Slade is right now holding his back because that bad Samoan drop that happened. And you could feel the mixed emotions from the fans hearing it saying, cheering for Raph or for Slade at the moment.
And Raph going for a pin.
This will be it. So one, two, and three.
And a three.
Yes. This is what I was talking about. The Raph kid was only messing around. And that's when he got serious.
And here is your winner, via pinfall, Raph.
Welcome to the home of the hillbilly. Yeah, baby, it's a land of barbed wire, moonshine, whiskey. Park your car before you get stuck. Go and grab your beer and get on up in the truck. It's going down tonight. It's all on me, it's BYOB, and I got all we need. Yeah, boy, I'm about to show me a set of slippers. How to kick it in the sticks with the critters down on the side of the barbed wire. Money grows and rolls, if it don't, you go broke. So we hang out by the bonfires. Just good old boys having a dang good time. We crank it up, we get loud. Throwing down in the dirty, dirty south down here. Be it all night.
Holy shit. Seriously, Mr. Hiccupley. Doesn't even make any sense.
Welcome to the Tilta World. All you motherfuckers are gonna die. You dying every day. Constantly. I kill myself right motherfucking now.
Speaking of juggling, here he comes.
Wicked clowns. Never die. What? Oh my goodie, look a chicken. Keep your money, it's a ticket. Hold up, keep your kids out here. They too young to play in there. Step right up, now strap them in. Lock it tight under his chin. Clamp his arms up to his side. It's gonna be a helly ride. Now if you miss
this place at night. I'm psychopathic, sure to find them. If you lose your nugget, yo, hatchet ain't responsible. Look and wonder if you will, cause we about to whip and kill. Think about your every sin as I tilt a whirly spin.
Apparently, we are being joined by Juggalo. Hello, Juggalo.
How can we help you?
Yeah. How's it going? I'm out here to sit here and watch this idiot Michael wrestle.
Alright, not a problem.
Oh, I see. Well, you know what I think? I think Jay should face you for the title. You know, just putting that out there.
What, that pompous asshole that lost to Wrath a couple weeks ago and lost all that money?
See, my point exactly.
You can't cheat when somebody else cheats and kicks you in the nuts.
Thank you.
Jay didn't cheat anything. I saw nothing. I was here. You guys are just seeing things and you're haters. You guys just hate on Jay because he's amazing. And you just want to be him. It's okay.
No. I don't need to be him. I'm sexy enough.
To each their own, I guess.
Damn right. Women love the clown.
Actually, I find the clown kind of scary.
Good.
That's the point on why he wears the makeup.
And on to the next match.
Come on, Mike, hurry up. We don't got all day, damn it.
Wow, why are you so impatient?
Hey, Rick, I'm a piece of beef jerky.
I'm going in the wind, I'm a big boy, right? I'll throw him down, I can't depend on our fight, cause you might kiss them all when you block it.
Clown flavor.
Standing at 6'3", weighing in at 175 pounds, the natural Michael Carson. Yes, you are, crybaby. Wow, wow, wow.
Aww, and see, I got blown up in that death match. And what did Jay do? You ran away.
And I hear this
I'm asking you this one.
Harmon.
Out of this one, yeah, I would literally agree Harmon would win this one. Harmon needs to win a match.
Yay! Harmon is not a wrestler. He's the referee.
But he should still win. He should still win.
Yes, I would totally agree on that one. Anyway, the match has started between Brandon and Michael.
Bro, do you smell festering flesh?
In a way, yes.
Wait, that's me.
You sure it's not Michael?
Michael just smells of B.O., and I think Brandon reeks of horrible talent.
Yes, the horrible talent is strong with Brandon. So, who knows with Michael?
Wow. Unbelievable.
For hard talent as Brandon... He's doing a pretty awesome job already.
Brandon being the rookie in this match.
And notice how I'm saying it sarcastically.
So, Juggalo, how's it going to feel when the number one contender, Michael Carson, beat you for your title? Are you going to whine? Are you going to come out here and whine?
Well, the thing is that I don't need to whine because I already know that he's not going to beat me. Because if we all saw him lose to Slade at the free preview.
So? That doesn't mean he can't beat you.
He got his ass handed by one of the rookies. I laughed.
Even though Michael does not have a winning streak, that doesn't mean that that can't change.
Well, he's going to have to try a lot harder than he is in this match.
That is true. Brandon going for it. I would agree with you, Juggalo. That even though I was injured last week for the pay-per-view, I was crying of laughter.
You were crying of laughter because you were injured?
Okay. No, because of Michael's incident.
And Michael with an eye rake. Look, see? Now he is a cheater.
Oh, don't start with the
cheater. Oh, look at that. That one snuck up on
really?
Me.
Really? Excuse 8 points, Juggalo. Dirty, dirty thing. Oh my god.
8 points, Jug.
Wow, you are so disgusting. I can see why you're single.
Like I said, you need to get used to Juggalo. I knowed him for many years.
I don't need to get used to anybody. Let's get one thing straight right now, okay?
No doubt about it. You could hear Michael and I was saying, come on, rookie, to Brandon. Already, this is definitely going to be a tough call for tonight. We got Brandon versus Michael. You can hear the fans' mixed crowd reaction between the two. This is definitely going to be tough down to call.
The rookie seems to be able to hold his own here, so...
It's because he's got size on the guy.
Size is nothing. He has some talent. Oh, Michael stopped loading.
See, and him doing that, it's gonna cost him a lot. Just like, oh, Mr. J. Frost.
Oh, I have money. I have money. Oh, look at that.
And he lost to Wrath.
Wrath cheated.
How did Wrath cheat?
Jay is still technically undefeated.
No, he's not. He lost in a steel cage match 2 weeks ago. And then he lost
no,
last
Wrath
week.
He got cheated.
Don't
if you
forget,
recall,
he got his ass
the steel cage
owned by the owner.
And he did what? What about Vince?
You didn't see how he got his ass owned by Vince himself.
Please. Vince kisses Jay's ass. Vince calls our house at least every freaking night kissing
Jay's ass. I
thought
he wasn't
Come
his
on.
Wife.
I'm not his wife. However, we do live together.
No,
not that that is
he's
any of our business. Yes, I am Jay's baby mama. That is correct.
Gold digger.
I'm a gold digger. I hold my own. I came into this relationship with money. I don't need Jay's money.
And you don't say you're his wife. Got it.
Is my last name Frost? No, I don't think it is. Therefore, no, we are not
he
married.
He must pay you a lot of money to hush everybody up for talking shit to him.
I don't have to hush anybody up. I speak right. the truth. It's not my fault if you...
Ooh, look at this. Now we know who wears the pants in that relationship.
That is true.
Really? Because I put you guys in your place and tell you to shut the hell up?
No.
All right.
Because we know how you treat Jay. Yeah, he bends over for you every night.
But does that he really? True. Wow. It's nice to know you guys have cameras at our house. Stalk is.
Red does. He likes to sit there and watch.
Ew, Red, you're fucking gross. Stalker, stop really stalking us. I know you're jealous of Jay and all, but that's a little crossing the line. Seriously?
Come on, Brandon. You can do this. Get up, kick Mike up. See, he's on the top rope.
Yep.
Just shake the rope.
Brandon's slow to get to his feet here. Michael stalking him.
See, the longer the match goes, Brandon's gonna get tired.
Oh, and Michael with a big Dragon Rana onto Brandon. He's going for a pin. Only a two count. Brandon kicks out.
Ref, you're counting slower. Count faster.
That
See,
would
even
be cheating.
Michael agrees with me. See, Michael even agrees with me.
Oh, of course Michael's going to agree with you. It's in his favor. Really,
favor,
Ref?
Whatever.
Seriously? Oh my god.
See, I could care less if Michael wins or not. Because he's going to have to come up against me, and he's not going to like it.
Yeah, he comes and feasts you when he beats you. And then Jay beats him again for the title. I already see it played out.
See, Jay's at the bottom of the barrel.
How is Jay at the bottom of the barrel when he's the Intercontinental Champion?
Because he got it out of absolutely nowhere.
For that title. It's not our fault.
Sure, by literally, yeah, sure, by winning it by means literally smacking him with a briefcase. Oh, yeah, that's right.
Yep.
His way through it.
Okay, what planet are you on? Because Jay never smacked Damian with no briefcase. It was Wrath who Jay smacked with the briefcase.
And thus we prove our point.
Hey, he deserved that for peeing in his tank.
Okay, well, if you recall, Raph started the whole entire thing when he shit in Jay's suitcase.
Hey, he left him a gift. That was a gift. He should have been grateful for that.
That was disgusting.
Hey, we always said Mr. Manapu is always a piece of shit. Well, there was the gift.
You know what, Red? You're a piece of shit.
Hey, at least I called out Halsey.
Yeah, and look at that. We got a three count. Jesus Christ.
And your winner, via pinfall, Michael Carson. There, Mr. Hiccopoly.
You're still calling that. Let's see, main event.
I am
event.
Going
yeah,
to
this
forever
is def-
call you that.
This
so
is definitely
going to
be interesting. We got the ex Divas champion versus with the current champion, and we got two contenders as well. So yeah, this is definitely going to be interesting.
And let's see who comes out first. Who do you think's going to win this match?
I would say probably the veterans. That would be Stacy and Jenny.
Really?
That's right. We got Stacy, who was the trainer of the gym at the time, who literally trained Eden and Phoenix at the time. So definitely it's going to be one interesting match.
Well, the trainer could be taught tonight.
That is true. One way to find out is by watching the show.
And I think Jenny is kind of a little afraid of Eden in a way. I mean,
oh, yeah,
Eden did make her cry last week. We can't forget that.
Afraid, probably petrified, nonetheless, due to fact. Eden did say once she's going to start changing things.
Oh.
Hey, what's up?
Well,
are you
gonna be Scott
our guest
Hex,
commentator?
What can we do for you?
You know, nothing much, you know. It's not like I was booked tonight because, you know, Vince doesn't like booking me. Don't you know that by now? Vince, some reason, has like a vendetta against me.
Exit stage left if you're not booked tonight.
How about you just sit there and keep on doing what you're doing, and I'll talk to Red.
Sweet.
Oh,
thank you.
No, I don't think so.
Sorry, you won't be with us tonight?
I'm pretty sure we need some kind of
security
out here right now.
No,
we don't need no security. Why wouldn't you need security?
Because you are not on
the
card, so
here,
and
you
should
half,
not be here,
like,
let alone sitting on the
here.
Side of me.
Yes.
Hey, you know what? I can do what I want when I want, because you know why? I said so. I don't care what Vince says.
And
I don't care what anybody says.
I'm sorry, who are you again? Because I'm pretty sure that
No. Excuse me. Who are you? I don't even know who the hell you are.
I am
you're not even a person I can even remember.
Good.
Alexander, who?
I will fill you in on who she is. She's literally the gold digger of Mr. Monopoly.
Oh, Moneybags, yeah. Another scared little person.
Scott, please.
Yeah, I think you better go listen to your wife.
Scott?
And.
Oh, I have to go stand up. Excuse me. What? What do you want? What? What?
Please. Enough, okay?
I say. When it's enough, and it trust me, it's not enough.
Please.
Listen, I have a vendetta against, you know, Vince, you know, because Vince likes making matches with rookie wrestlers and getting them completely hurt and injured and putting them into the hospital. And doesn't know when to leave people alone. Oh, speaking of which, ladies and gentlemen, this checking shit himself, Vince Aftermath.
Whoa, just who in the hell you think you are, Mr. Scott Hicks? Who do you think you are?
The person that brings the people in this place puts the money in your pocket.
Excuse me, shut your mouth, I'm talking right now.
No, shut your mouth, blah, 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 blah,
really? You shut
really?
Your mouth out there, okay?
Really?
You listen to me.
Really?
Okay?
All I'm hearing is diarrhea fly through your mouth. What?
Mr. Scott, your wife, Mrs. Dixie over here, has told you to shut your pie hole. How about you go back to the house and be a couch potato, okay? I don't want you here. We don't need you here. I suggest.
How about you grow those grapefruits that you so-called have and get your ass into this ring there and say it right to my face and see what happens.
Security, get this guy out of my ring. Someone get him out of here. Get him out of here. I don't care. Just get him out of here some kind of way. Eject him. Whatever. Get him out of here. I want him gone. We got a freaking segment here.
Thank you, Vince.
I'm sorry, Vince.
Damn it.
And that is how you take out the trash.
Alright, we're starting from the top, okay? I'm coming out to do my segment here. Yeah. Don't worry about the music. Yeah. Alright, thank you. Alright, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Virtual Attitude Wrestling Elite here tonight. We got ourselves, as you can see so far, we have got ourselves a great show going on, but tonight we are here to honor someone here and bring someone. I'm sorry, I'm kind of off my. Some people. That's all I got to say. It's just some people. But anyway, we're here to honor some people. Or a person, and as the weeks go on, we'll be honoring some people into the VAW Hall of Fame. This individual here has came into the Virtual Attitude Wrestling at the start of Virtual Attitude Wrestling and really put the women's division on the map. She really came out with her skills and ability and came to the Virtual Attitude Wrestling with no hesitation. And as we bring her into the Hall of Fame, this is our way of saying thank you. Thank you for your hard work, your dedication, and your commitment of being here and overall dealing with me, because that's already a commitment and dedication right there. But well, that's on a whole nother note. But she has returned back here to Virtual Attitude Wrestling to stand back into a Virtual Attitude Wrestling ring to take this honor here. And I want to bring her on out, come on out and, talk to these great people out here, come on out.
Actually, really hard to
have. I can't play.
seen her come back in a long time. She's new. Now a veteran of the Golden Bass has done something right. He has now shown us that Lily Martinez is now the diva who is going to be lit.
All right, first of all, oh, thank you, too. I definitely wanted to say thank you for all your hard work, all the jokes and the glitz and the glamour aside. You have really you really put our division on the map when we first started. You know, we were nothing, but if it wasn't for your hard work and dedication at the start and it, you know, we wouldn't be where we are now in terms of just the VAW period. You know, we all have to start somewhere, and we have to thank those who helped us get to that point, you know. And you clearly did that, and I really do thank you for that.
I'm gonna read what she's saying. She says she likes to, she enjoyed it much first thing running here at VAW. And she says that I think it's great to be back in the spring in front of the crowd, especially.
Yep, and we are glad to have you back in this ring.
Uh-oh, here we go. Really? Here comes trouble.
Am I seeing things? Is this really Lily Martinez? Are you kidding me? But apparently my eyes do not see her, because it is Lily. Lily, it's great to see you back in the VAW. And especially in the Hall of Fame, as you were one of the first women on the roster. Although, you're doing this because you want to hide from wrestling. Because you were a little bit rusty. So, I got a little challenge for you. How about you and me next week? To show which is the better wrestler and which one has the least rust.
Alright, I'm still going to talk to her about it. She says, well, Stacy, I wasn't going to announce it tonight, but see what she's got to say. I gave a little hint. See these wrestling boots?
Of course I see those wrestling boots. Duh, I have eyes.
Not only I signed legend deal with VAW, but full-time wrestling contract.
Oh, really? That is so wonderful.
Yep, ladies and gentlemen, Lily Martinez is now a full member here in Virtual Attitude Wrestling. That was the second announcement, but you go ahead and take it away there, Stacy Grace. Congratulations to you again, Lily.
I'll see you next week, Stacy.
Consider it a challenge, Lily.
And after I get through with you, I'll become 2-time women champion.
A 2-time? Okay. We'll see. Just, you'll see.
Well, you heard the fact, we got a new contract signed by the legend, Lily Martinez. So next week, we got a match already underway. Lily versus Stacy Grace. That's going to be one interesting match. I know what both women are like. This is definitely going to be interesting.
I agree with you. It's going to be nice to see Lily back in the ring.
No doubt about it. This will be, I believe, her first time ever appearing at VAW again. So,
baby, can't you see? I'm calling. I got a hint. You put a warning. It's dangerous. I'm falling.
Tag team match. Ooh, I've been waiting all night to see this.
So have I, ladies and gentlemen, and especially for the men.
Of course you have.
This is the women's, Divas tag team match, which means we get to see women for now.
Okay.
Let's see who comes out first.
Quit your drooling. Close your mouth. Turn the tits.
And speaking of which,
country roads of West Virginia, standing at 5'10", weighing 135 pounds, Stacy Grace.
Wait, that's not Stacy Grace's music. That's Jenna's music.
And her partner, hailing from Chicago, Illinois.
Jenna, like Forrest Gump, Jenna.
Okay,
Jenna. Okay, whatever.
be worth a trillion.
Well, this is definitely going to be an interesting match. You got two veterans of the ring versus two newcomers. Well, not technically new, but you know what I mean. This is definitely going to be an interesting match.
Well, I wouldn't call Phoenix and Eden new at all. They may not be as veteran as Stacy and Jenny, but definitely not new.
That is true. But in any case, this is definitely going to be interesting. Where we got the Divas tag match. I believe this is probably the first time we had a tag. And it looks like Phoenix is literally dominating the match so far by doing those kicks and Irish whip to Stacy.
Let the smack talking begin.
Smack talking has been going on. And already with that shoulder stretch, she's just warming things up. And there goes those punches by Stacy Grace. And as I said before, the match started away. Stacy taught both Eden and Phoenix before they became VAW Elite status. So, in a way, they haven't learned everything that both of the champions and former champion had taught them. So, definitely, it's going to be interesting. And I see Eden's yelling at me. I'm sorry. She didn't taught you. Okay. Who taught you then?
I think Eden pretty much taught herself.
No problem. But anyway, you get your Jenny say tag me. It's not Jenny.
Oh, goodness. That's right, Eden. You tell him. He's a dumbass.
That's Andy. That's not pure pro wrestling. As you say, there's nothing pro.
And Stacy just stomping on Phoenix like no tomorrow.
And I would have to agree with Jenny for once that she needs to stop running her mouth in order to pay attention to the match.
Oh, we have a tag. Here comes Jenny.
That is right, and here comes Jenny already. Let's see what she's going to do.
I think Jenny's more looking forward to getting her hands on Eden than anything.
Now, anyway, it looks like Stacy and Jenny is doing a double tag move known as a high and low combo, which I would have to agree most of, well, probably injured the legs at most, bet, due to the fact the way Stacy was going at earlier. And you see Harmon already seeing Stacy out of the ring. And you hear fans trying to cheer for Phoenix, trying to get up as possibly as she can. But the way this match is, Jenny is literally... Okay, so she accidentally, possibly, or I don't know, let me review. Oh, I see what happened. She was going to do a Irish rope shoot and everything, but Eden basically pulled the ropes. Anyway, back in the ring with Jenny with a dropkick.
Oh, with a huge dropkick from behind.
Now, you were saying you were not sure who's going to win this match?
I don't know, because I've seen Eden wrestle over the past few weeks, and she is quite good, and I would not call her a rookie. Phoenix, on the other hand, yeah, she's not so good.
And that is true. Well, no about it. Like I said,
interesting.
That's right. Well, my money's on both Stacy and Jenny. Due to the fact they're more experienced than Eden and Phoenix, so who knows what we're going to see for tonight. Are we going to see a comeback with Eden and Phoenix dominating the match, or are we going to see literally Stacy controlling it with Jenny as they continue on this battle?
I do look forward to when Eden gets in the ring with Jenny, though.
Well, Eden has a
point. Well, Eden, that's Eden. Because you stole it from Jenny. I mean, let's be realistic.
That is right.
Here.
This is probably the third time she stole it.
No, I'm pretty sure that you have not beaten her for the title. You stole her title.
And it looks like Jenny's on her free time trying to get back up where she's yelling at Eden.
I think Jenny should just let Phoenix tag Eden in and let them two go at it.
But definitely, this is definitely going to be an interesting match already. Phoenix and her tag partner is dominating so far. But Jenny uphands
Jenny
with the
ground tackling Phoenix to the ground, punching her in the face. Showing her who the veteran wrestler is right now.
And with a moonside, that had to hurt.
Eden eager to be tagged into this match.
Well, who could blame her? And Jenny going out with a roundabout crossbody, which connects. Can she make the tag in order to continue on with this match?
Both and ladies down on the mat the fans looking on for this a one. Tag. Who is going to get to their corner first?
You can hear Eden literally saying it's boring. She wants to go in. You can see her pacing around the ring saying that she wants to be tagged in, but she can't do nothing about it.
And Jenny going for a pin!
It'll be 1, 2, and
oh,
somehow
and
managed with a
out.
Kick out. Just somehow Jenny didn't have it in time. You hear Stacy saying, what was that all about? But no doubt about it, this is definitely going to be a tough call for us tonight, folks.
And a huge Irish whip to the corner. Here goes Jenny with the punches. She is not letting up on Phoenix.
And the only thing Eden can do right now is just sit in the corner and watch on as Phoenix literally gets destroyed one by
Eden
one.
Eden just needs to calm her tits. She'll get in there soon enough.
Oh, with a vicious thump, can she make the tag? And she does.
And Phoenix gets the tag.
Now
here
this
we
is
go.
Where
Eden versus Jenny Porter.
And that's right. Now the fear of God wakens up in Jenny as she sees God the Maker Eden come down to kick her ass.
may have the slight advantage here, seeing as she is fresh to come into the ring, and Jetty's been in there quite a while now.
That may be true, but who knows what's going to happen. As we do know, both of them does have a grudge between each other. So this is definitely going to be interesting now. This is where we're seeing Eden possibly looking for a double tag move if she stays in that corner. Oh, and a sitting face buster. That had her hurt, no doubt about it. Let's see what Eden does now. Now it looks like we lost connection with the co-commentator, but it's okay, I can fill in for it right now. And with the pin, with only a 2 count, Eden gets up frustrated, looking at the ref, and you can see she's pissed off. She wants to win this match for her team. And you can see Phoenix is gladly taking a break on the side of the rope while Stacy looks on from the other side. And Eden, with each stomp she makes, is harder and harder upon Jenny at the moment. You could hear the fans trying to say, "Hey, Stacy, save Jenny." And then they got some saying, "Stacy, are you okay?" and everything like that. But Phoenix is just laughing. She just said, she's just laughing her ass off over there. While Eden is literally kicking Jenny's ass everywhere in the ring. If it ain't one side of the corner, it's the other way. And with that vicious slap, that had her hurt. And there goes those corner gut punches. And this is why I tell the people in the ring or out of the ring, you do not want to stand in corners. Due to the fact, this is why. I mean, literally, Eden is literally destroying Jenny. It's just destroying her. Like, really.
Eden definitely showing her dominance right here.
And
after all,
back.
She did beat Jenny Porter once in a non-title match.
That
Ever
is
since
true.
Then, she thinks that she owns her pretty much.
And, oh, the enziguri from by Eden from the corner back there. Can Jenny literally recuperate at this time?
Jenny desperately needs to tag Stacy in.
No doubt about it. I would not disagree with you on that one. You can see Stacy eerily pacing on, but looks like Eden is just toying with Jenny.
Now she is. Standing over her. Ooh, and stomping her in the face. Oh, and Jenny getting the tag on Stacy.
And here we go with another fresh spawn, this time with Stacy. And Stacy literally welling on Eden at the moment. But with the Luthes press, this could be it already with Eden.
Stacy with a huge tilt-a-whirl backbreaker to Eden.
That had to be it. It connected perfectly. And wait a minute. Uh-oh. This cannot be good. Eden literally stopped that kick by Stacy. This cannot be good.
Ooh. And a big leg sweep kick. Stacy is looking like she may have hurt herself.
That is true. After all, that much damage from the foot, that had to hurt.
And an Irish whip to the ropes.
No doubt about that one. It has to hurt with a combo of a clothesline into a flapjack. Postman Stacy, who went for a clothesline, but Eden countered it with a flapjack. And going with a tag with the first spawn is now Phoenix, just going up against Stacy. If you can hear the fans cheered on.
I guess Eden needed herself a little break.
That is right. And Phoenix with a vertical suplex. Can she complete the suplex? And she does. Slamming Stacy right on her back. That had to hurt.
That hurts me just watching.
No doubt about that one. And there she goes. Oh! I believe that's called the pump handle power slam. Just slamming Stacy right down like nothing. And just stomping on her head just to make things worse. I believe this is it, folks. The way things are, I believe Phoenix is going to win it right now. With a vicious leg drop. This could be it. Here comes the pin. And could this be it? It's
a
one.
For a pin.
Two.
Could this be it? Stacy kicks out.
Almost a three, but no dice. Stacy kicks out of nothing. And Jenny right in the middle of the ring. What is she doing?
Jenny's doing is catching her breath.
Oh! Reversal by Stacy with the head scissor takedown. Now we see Stacy going at it now with Phoenix. But no dice. Phoenix retaliates. Oh! And I believe that'd be it. And wait a minute, what's going on here? One, two, three. Oh my god. And already, Jenny came in to
Eden
save.
Got into the ring to stop Stacy.
But no dice.
Jenny wasn't having none of that.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, your winners for the main event, Jenny Porta and Stacy Grace Rage. You gotta give it up for these two. Wait. I think we might see a line.
$1 trillion. Get the feeling that you don't really give a Miss Hilton, I like the way you push and glide. All the skates, all the social butterflies.
Look right now.
What do you want to say? I beat you. You should just be in the back right now. What could you possibly want to say to me?
Jenny, you fucking bitch. Are you sure you want to mess with me again?
Eden, I'm not scared of you. And I think this match just proved it right here, right now.
Really? Wow, how quickly you forget I beat you just a few weeks ago and stole your precious title. Or how about the fact that I made you cry in front of your adoring fans just last week?
She does have a point.
Maybe you really are as stupid as everyone says, but you just messed with the wrong bitch, Jenny.
Uh-oh.
You know what, Eden? Bring it, because...
So, next week, we're going to have ourselves a rematch. It will be you and me for the VAW Women's Championship.
Bring it, because I'm not scared of you, Eden. I'm not. I'm not going to let you push me around anymore.
And it won't be just your last shot at the title. It will be your last match ever, because next week, I'm not just going to beat you and officially become the champion. I'm going to end your career.
I'm not scared of you, Eden. Come on, Stacey, let's go.
And notice how she runs to the back.
All right, there you have it, folks. Next week, right here on Elite, we will have the VAW Women's Champion, Jenny Porter, putting her belt on the line against Eden Cunningham.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, that has been VAW Elite. I am Red Blackheart. Alongside of me is Alexvedia Henley.
Oh, God, you can't even say it right still. It's Alexavia Heaney. I don't care anymore. Right.
This is the end of the show where I say fuck it. Either way, ladies and gentlemen, this is going to be an interesting...